Good morning, friends.
Now, as we will be starting with this DT course, let me just give you a brief idea how we are going to cover this course, what will be duration, where we have to concentrate upon, and all such points. So, now, as per your new curriculum, which will be applicable for May 18, income tax is going to be for roughly 70 marks and international taxation will be for 30 marks. That is what they have prescribed, that weightage. Now, this division, I think so, that very specifically they will ask 30 marks now on your international taxation and rest will come in your normal tax law. Now, when we talk about this international taxation, then in that particular case, or one can say non-resident ka taxation, Income Tax Act will play an important role because we have to study so many chapters from Income Tax Act itself and then we have to move to certain other treaties, base erosion concepts and then transfer pricing rules. So, if we can divide this as syllabus chapter wise, then these many chapters, that is total 41 chapters, that is what we have to study basically. Now, for this every chapter, I have tried to make an ABC analysis, that is from your exam point of view, whatever is most relevant has been put into A category and whatever is least important has been put into C category. If you can see what is being highlighted here in yellow color, talks about all your those chapters which have been covered in non-resident taxation or international taxation. So obviously we'll be covering all those things along with this in this entire structure itself. We will be covering both normal taxation, that is income tax, and international taxation. So let us quickly revise which all chapters we have to study. We'll start with house property, which is a very basic one. Then clubbing, basis of charge, and in this way this list will go on. Now, this entire syllabus, what we have to complete, I have specifically tried to cover it into 160 hours of learning. So, your total virtual lectures will be roughly around about 160 hours. Now, along with that, notes will be provided to you for reference, and I think these notes will be sufficient for you for your exam also. Along with that, obviously, you have to solve sums from your study material, then RTP, and if any additional reference book if you want to. Now that is obviously subjective if you want to. As I've already told you, I've divided this syllabus into 41 chapters, so you have to study this 41 chapters. If you have noticed one thing, every chapter has been categorically analyzed as ABC, that is as per their importance, and further when you will go to every chapter section wise, I have tried to give you ABC analysis of every section so that it will be helpful for you to concentrate upon most important sections first and then to go to least important. Now in our lectures primarily we will be concentrating on clearing our concepts, that would be our prime objective, so that whenever you are going through those particular notes or going through particular that topic again, then it will be very very easy for you to understand and make it applicable while solving sums. Now when we'll be discussing this, all the chapters, whichever chapters are most important, like PGBP, capital gain, assessment procedure, special rate, and now in non-resident taxation, transfer pricing, right? Then non-resident ka special rates, all this will obviously, more weightage will be given, we'll spend more time in understanding those chapters. And in addition to that, those new concepts which you normally don't do in your offices, which is something very very new to you, we'll try to give more weightage to that by giving more time for understanding, giving more time on learning those things. So in this way, we'll be trying to cover our entire syllabus in roughly 160 hours.